tries to strike out the side, and she does. A high and outside, chased by Fleet, and three up and three down with three strikeouts. Bryant, 2-2 pitch, swing and a miss. Looked like she took something off that, but again, that looked like a rise ball or something. And once again, striking out the side. So Crimson Bryant has started the ball game off with six straight strikeouts out. The runner second, the 0-2 pitch, tried to check the swing, went too far, and another strikeout for Crimson Bryant. Popped up down the third baseline, her second time up. Swings and hits a pop-up behind the home plate, and it's grabbed by Anahi Velasquez for out number three, and ending 0-for-1. And the first pitch to Addison, swung on and slowly hit to the shortstop. It's fielded by Longview. No throw, an infield single by Addison DeSmith. Here's a 1-1 pitch. Bunted on, a beautiful bunt by Paris Pickett. Fielded by Rios. Throw to first is not in time. And now here's a throw to third, and it is going to... Oh, it's safe. They missed the tag at third base. Looked like it was in time to get this net. But she got in there with a slide. Been there a long time on the microphone. Two balls and two strikes. Here's the ball hit out to center field, and Harper makes the catch out there. And Rios, 1-0 pitch, bunted, but back to Rios. She fields and throws to first, but it's dropped by the first baseman. So Nyla Lindley is on the air. And the next pitch on the way, inside, and the throw to first, and Nyla Lindley streaking to second, and she will steal second base. The Ladycats, Bryant with 1-0 pitch, bunted beautifully down to the first baseman. Nobody covering first base, and Nyla Lindley goes to third. And boy, she thought about coming home, but and the 2-0 pitch on the way. Got through with a wild pitch. Here comes Nyla Lindley, the throw, not in time. And the Lady Cats lead 1-0. That's what I was going to mention a while ago. Shall I say the wild pitch? And that's exactly what we got, but I didn't say it in time, so I don't know I can claim it. I can all tell you. Here's a 3-2 pitch. Swing and a miss, and the Lady Cats win an improbable game tonight by the score of 1-0.
Playoffs. I'm not going to put money down on it because I'm not a gambling man, but I see a lot of potential in both of these teams. Both teams are led by all right, ace dynamite pitching. Grab yourself and the Lady Cats will be Crimson Bryant, who is just out of Agostino. And show Jets me the first money swinging, like so just like that, hey, line goes 1-2-3 down the lineup to get three strikeouts. Big spoon is my name, Big Bloom. I keep it popping like a needle in a new balloon. So just like that, there's now seven straight batters that Crimson Bryant has struck out. And that's pitching away. Jets, Maddie Cox, swinging. She slices it into deep left field, but it'll fly far. Nicole Higgins looks like she's going to come down and make the play on it, and she does to get the final outfield at the top of the fourth. So just like that, Hank Adell's able to slice it into shallow infield. It is deep enough that it's just past the infield and shallow. And Jones pitched away. She's able to get it right past the second baseman, and just like that, Ken Smallwood advances to second, Bryant gets to first. So now there are two runners aboard. Ken Smallwood, pitch running Madison Cadell at second, and now Bryant, who just got the hit, is at third. And she's able to rehab nail it past the second baseman, and just like that, Ken Smallwood is able to advance home. And the pitch does not go to the catcher in time and falls out of the glove, and just like that, number 13, Ken Smallwood, pitch running for Addison Cadell, is able to get home and take the lead for Sulphur Springs, making a 1-0 game at least 1-1. And that gets away from her, and just like that, Kimmy Fritter will advance home. And just like that, wow. Ramirez is able to get a nice cut. But unfortunately for her, it went straight to Paris Pickett. That's a Sulphur Springs. It's a dangerous situation with runners at first and second. And only one out. And so 2 pitches away. And gets her swing. Get set, 2-2 pitches away. Hello, nurse. And gets her swinging to get through the inning, so just like that. And every reverse, I look is right on the money. Yo, I got more racks than a mummy. And Kadari nails it. It's a shallow left field. He's able to advance to first. Fought long and hard about advancing to second, but the throw got over to the second. It's a shortstop in time to the Red Hills from advancing. So, yet again, has a hit, and she is now, I believe, 2-3 for the mission that we know. Harris Pickett sends it right past the second baseman, and just like that, Harrison Cadell will advance home. It looks like Kelly Quintermite, but she stays at third in a very smart decision there, as the Ladycats are able to get one more run on the board thanks to Harris Pickett's RBI single. And just like that, Crimson Bright strikes out Jerry Nelson to get the final out of the evening and the victory. So just like that, the Sulphur Springs Ladycats are able to lead here victorious.
Audio Jack.
And guess the strikeout. Nasty pitch there to get Brazier Hargrave out in the third out of the inning. So Crimson Bright's able to get two strikeouts in the bottom of the first. Hargrave pitches away. And Pickett is able to get a hit, and it goes right past the shortstop there and is able to advance to first. And so now, Nicole Higgins, who was just hit by a pitch, is on second with Paris Pickett on first. So it's 1-2 count, pitches away, and gets the strikeout. So Crimson Bright has now struck out. Five straight batter on the new Paul Lindley, the first baseman. Oh, wow, and she bunts it, and bunts it beautifully over to the third baseman. And the third baseman does not come down in time to get the throw over to first. And so, Paul Lindley is able to advance to first after bunting. Very impressive bunt there. And she is able to get the strikeout. So Bryant gets yet another strikeout, and that will be the eighth straight batter. Higgins trying to do her best to get advance her home, and she nails it into, looks like it'll be deep left field. Will anyone come down with it? And she gets a home run, a two-run homer by Nicole Higgins there to break the 0-0 tie. A very impressive blast there is able to get Higgins and the pinch runner for Cadell home. The pitch. She nails it into deep center field. Will J.D. Harper be able to come down with it? And she sure does to get that first out. And Paris Pickett is able to nail it right past the third baseman and not into foul territory. So Pickett turns first for extra bases to get over to second. And she stays. And she nails it over the shortstop. And Harper may get some extra bases on this one. And it looks like she really thought about it. Right field, but it looks like Ella Cross again comes down with it. And it looks like Dez just tagged and advanced to home. So very impressive play there. So it will amount to a sacrifice fly for Maddie Smith, who get a 4-1 victory over the Mount Pleasant Lady Tiger.
I was thinking about this. Bitch on the news, yeah, they see about this. Even in the paper, they gon' read about this. Cause all of my life, training day and night, I'm preparing to fight for everyone, never leave. Crowds going insane, yeah, they screaming our name while we spraying champagne. Nothing nobody can say. Cause today is the day, is the day that I have always dreamed of. Forever, when you call me, you call me the champ of the world. I can raise my hands, I can scream out the best in the world, whole world. All my blood, sweat, and grind was all for this time. Level up, mile after mile, push up after push up, everybody count it out. Everybody up, now we back down to all our pain and sweat was for this moment right now. All from different places, but we came with each other. We came together as a team, but we leaving as brothers. Standing next to one another while we hold up our colors.
I'm gonna look into the camera, tell my mama I love her.
Cause today is the day, is the day that I have always dreamed of. Forever, when you call me, you call me the champ of the world. I can raise my hands, I can scream out the best in the world. All my blood, sweat, and grind was all for this time.
Today is the day that I have always dreamed of. And forever, when you call me the champ of the world.
I can raise my hands, I can scream out the best in the world, whole world. All my blood, sweat, and grind was all for this time. Today is the day.
Opportunity here for Lehman. All she has to do is hit it into the outfield, and Woods will come home to score. The crowd on their feet once again for a huge situation here in the top of the eighth. Big swing and a miss for strike one. Bryant looking to continue her success so far, and the bunt attempt will not be successful. 0-2. This a big pitch right here. A hit gives Huntsville the lead, and out heads us to the bottom of the eighth with no score. Right now the 0-2, that one swung on and fouled away. Inning stays alive thanks to the foul ball. Hope Grant stands on deck. Lehman, eager to get her first hit of the ball game, will swing and miss there. And that will send us to the bottom of the eighth. Magnuson at the plate currently. 1-for-3 in the ball game with a double back in the first inning. That one missing the zone, 2-0. The 2-0. Missing high, 3-0. On deck, Addison Cadell. In the circle, or due up, Crimson Bryant. Nobody on base, one out in the circle. Duke ready for the 3-0 pitch. That high, ball four. And the at the plate, Addison Cadell. First pitch high for a ball. A 1-0. And that one in there for a strike. This one a bunt right in front of home plate. Throw to first. That one in plenty of time for out number two. Runner advancing to second base. Crimson Bryant, pitcher on pitcher duel with the winning run in scoring position and two outs. First pitch is outside for a ball. Swing and a miss, 1-1. Only one hit for Cadell so far. This one a pop-up that'll go out of play. Winning run on second, the 2-2. This one swung on and lifted down the line and right, they're gonna say fair. The run will come home. And Sulphur Springs will walk off game one.
First pitch, this is hit well in the center. The end's gonna give it a look, but it is gone. And it's 1-0 Sulphur Springs. On a two-out solo shot from Nicole Higgins. Eric Hiley's and Grisham Woods. Here's the pitch to Hartford. Woods will look up. Goodbye. Set up a double play on the infield. Here's the first pitch to Lindley. Swung on, base hit, left field. One run will score. The throw to third is not in time. Everyone advances up 60 feet. 4-2, Sulphur Springs. There's the 2-2 to Magnuson. It bounces in and gets away from Grisham. 6-2. Three times tonight. The 1-0 to Cadell is hit in the center. Vian will give it a look, but it's off the base of the wall. One run will score. It's 7-3 as Sulphur Springs gets the insurance they need. The plate. The pitch popped up. Might stay in play. It's over.
She was staring out the window of their SUV, complaining, saying, I can't wait to turn 18. She said, I'll make my own money and I'll make my own rules. Mama put the car in park out there in front of the school. And she kissed her head and said, I was just like you. You're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times. So take a good look around. You may not know it now, but you're gonna miss this. Before she knows it, she's a brand new bride in her one-bedroom apartment, and her daddy stops by. He tells her it's a nice place. She says, it'll do for now. Starts talking about babies and buying a house. Daddy shakes his head and says, baby, just slow down. Cause you're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times. So take a good look around. You may not know it now, but you're gonna miss this.